Okay, so I've been wanting to do a Factions Let's Play series for a while, but I haven't been able to find a server. I went around looking for servers, and I couldn't really enjoy them though because I don't really like to start having to start over. So I did think of this server, which I've actually been playing on for about 2 years now. I am a donator, so I do get a lot of kits, and I also get fly. But I don't think it'll be used not that much. But I was thinking about starting a series on here, and I might. This is just gonna be episode 1. It's a test episode, I guess, just to see how it goes. And yeah. So I'm just in the end looking for wither skeletons, and I think I do have an idea though to get them easier. Another blaze spawner. Let's not mess with that one. So let me go commander chest. Let's get a spawner. And let's come down here. This isn't very far from, well, it's not very far from anything. But I will try to hide it. Just cover that. Okay, so I'll just pick like the little room down here. And then I'll put the spawner in there. I think it still works if you put a skeleton spawner in it. In the Nether, it sometimes spawns wither skeletons, so that'd be pretty helpful. I think that still works. I need a different pick. I don't want to waste that one. And this server might lag a bit. It kind of does lag sometimes. The owner got a new host because I told him to, but yeah, he got a new host. It's a little better, but sometimes there's still lag spikes. I don't know why. Could be outdated plugins. Again, this used to be a problem a long time ago. Had a lot of outdated plugins, so it was really laggy. But hopefully, it won't lag too much. Yeah, so just clear this out. My pick's about to break already. Let's use this, I don't care. Almost done. Let's just put this down. Actually, let's do this. This is probably a better idea. Maybe. Okay, and then put that down. Let's do some spawner skeleton. They'll spawn. Oh yeah, there they go. I guess he's suffocating. Is that block glitch or something? I'll relog. Yeah, it's glitched. Okay, so I cut that because it was me logging in, and that's what I think a server is. It's crack server. So if people just download like a little fake launcher, they can just make any username they want. Let me find an example. I don't know, but I think there's someone on here called Player or something. Yeah, his name's Player, but you can just make fake names. So people sometimes, if they want to, they can log in as you. So that's why they have the password plugin, so they can't without your password. And that's pretty good. I don't really like crack servers because, I don't know, I feel like a lot of people, I feel like a lot of people hack, okay, because it's really easy, they don't need a real account or anything, they can just come on with a million different, names, and it doesn't really matter, but whatever, I'll just probably stay here for a while and get some wither skulls. I don't even know if the wither is still enabled or not. So, let's see, actually, let's still get my roof hooked first. Let's do. Right here, set home, wither. Party scroll, finally. Okay, so we got one scroll so far. I'll probably just stay here until I get a few, and I'll probably ask around if the wither is still enabled. So I'll be back. Did I finish? No, almost. On the old server, on this server, like 4 or 5 resets ago, I did have a pretty big cane farm. I think it was like 250 by 250 or something like that. It was really big, and I got a ton of money from it, but the server has reset many times since then, so that's, I'm not really rebuilding it, but I'm making a big one anyway. It's not too big, I think it's like, I don't know, if you want to count, go ahead, I'm not going to, but, yeah, it's a good, what's the word, it's a good thing to farm for MCMMO, and MCMMO is actually a skills plugin on the server. So if I right click with my hand, it says I ready my fists. So what that does is like a combat advantage, and if you farm that, you're what's it called? Unarmed. You can disarm people. Like if you're fighting and you start punching them, if it's high enough, you get a higher and higher chance of disarming them, so they can drop their sword and whatever they're holding. Like sometimes, one of my fights, people actually made me drop my golden apples. So that's pretty good. They can drop their sword or anything else that's giving them an advantage from you. And yeah, some servers actually have that disabled though, because it's really OP, as you can imagine. If you just go in a fight with nothing and you punch someone and they just drop everything and you kill them, that'd be really bad. People might rage quit servers. Yeah, I don't know. So I'll just finish building this, and then I'll start planting a little bit. Okay. That's gonna take a while to plant though. It's pretty big. I only have 2.5 stacks of sugarcane. I keep misplacing that, I don't know why. I guess I have no control over my clicks. That's cool. Yeah, this farm is actually really far from spawn. so I don't think it'll be found. It's actually at one of the borders. I can say that. It's at one of the borders. It's really far. So yeah. I don't think it'll be found. If it is, I don't really care. It's just sugarcane. My vault isn't even near here, so it doesn't really matter to me. I would never actually make my vault out of border, because that's really obvious. Like, some people make it at 0-0 or 10,000. That's too obvious for me. Like, if I was going to go look for raids, I'd be around those courts. And, yeah. One time I found a raid at 0-0, which was really dumb, but it was like a really good raid. But I wouldn't do that. That's too obvious. Yeah, so I'll need a lot of sugarcane to fill this up. And I also need a lot of slabs to cover the water so it doesn't fall in the ocean. I might eventually make walls, but I'll need a lot of stone for that. That's one thing about making big farms, is you need a lot of materials to do it. Even though a lot of profit, it takes a while to get profit, because it takes a while to build. Unless you start like with people giving you all of this sugarcane. That's what happened to the other farm I talked about, the big one. People actually gave me stacks of dirt, so that helped a lot. I didn't have to go digging for hours for, I think it was like 500 stacks of dirt or something. I don't know. Something like that. Probably not that many. I think it's like 50 stacks, actually. But anyway, yeah, that's... I'll just have to kind of AFK here at one point for it to grow. But not right now. I didn't actually bring my arrows. That's smart. No. Yeah, I have no arrows. So I guess that'll be the end of this first episode, because I don't really have any plans to do anything else right now. Maybe later I'll try to find a raid, but not right now. I still need to set my vault up. As you see, it wasn't actually obsidian, it's still stone, so I do need to go mining for that. I won't do that on camera because that's really boring, I understand. I'll just do that at some point. My friend actually did give me a home in the end, so that's pretty nice. I'll go mining for obsidian there. Someone else also gave me this obsidian. I was really ripped off for it, actually. I think it was paid like 20k for 3 stacks, but that's fine. So yeah, that's about it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed it. I know it's kind of boring right now, because I have nothing to do, but hopefully next episode will be better. So yeah.